And that all went a little bit pear-shaped for Jose Mourinho's side. After the game, Jose said, was obviously asked, you know, what's happening to you? Because they're a team that seem to not like to hold on to leads. They do give away goals. And you said yesterday on the show as well, their weakness is their defence. And that was proven yesterday. He said, though, after people were asking questions of, you know, what's happening to your teams? He said, it's the same coach, different players. What do you make of his reaction?
I personally think there's been an ongoing issue. I don't believe he likes particularly any of his back line. If you think at the start of the season, you could pick a completely different back four, whether it was Davis, Alderweireld, Eric Dier, Aurier. Yesterday, none of them played. You could put Doherty in there, and you're looking at Sanchez, then obviously Rodon. I'm not convinced that he really likes his defenders. And yesterday, he's justified by the way he sees it. They need massive work in them areas in the back line. The first goal was so typical of Tandanya, played right back yesterday. And he lost the ball trying to clear it. Then Davison tries to clear a header, gives away the ball. Newcastle comes straight back at Tottenham, and that is Tottenham. They're so easy to play against, and I think he doesn't like. I don't think he trusts many of them. I think probably he's fell out with one or two of them along the way. I was so refreshing to hear a manager actually point the fingers at the player, because I said to you over the weekend, didn't I, when Arteta came on and said, I take total responsibility, and I think, come on. You've got to be prepared to let your players know. You've trained, you work all week on things. If they get it wrong, you know, what do you do as a manager of your two of your defenders? Well, the argument always is, well, you select them.
Yeah.
But you selected a completely different back four at times, and it's still an occurring theme. Individual mistakes. You lose games, you cost points.
Well, it's not only that, is it? It's game management, isn't it, as well? There's that element. I know Scott Parker spoke about that after their defeat at Aston Villa, knowing that when you've got 15, 10 minutes to go, know how to manage the game. But yet there are players, as Scott Parker alluded to, that probably didn't do that right in that game yesterday. And that's probably the same for Tottenham, you could say. There are experienced players out there, but if you're continuously conceding goals, which either leads to you drawing a game or losing a game, I see where you're coming from. You know, Jose Mourinho is picking his side to do a job. He's expecting that 11 out there on the pitch to do the job that they have been trained to do. There's only so much a manager can do. Yes, he can make substitutions and try and change the game in their favour. But ultimately, if there are sloppy mistakes that are made time and time again,
that's players.
Yeah. What can a manager do?
Sam Allardyce on Friday talked about his strikers and talked about the amount of chances they create. And the chances don't take, the strikers don't take their chances. They miss them. What do you do as a coach or a manager, apart from change the team, if you have forwards that get opportunities, don't score, they miss? That they're big moments in games. So it's the same with defenders. If a defender makes an individual mistake, that's going to cost you points. You're not going to win enough football games. So I find it as a strange argument, because Fulham should have got something at Villa yesterday, you know, and I'm sure we'll talk about that game a bit later. Fulham done well enough to get something from Villa Park. An individual mistake at 1-1 ends up costing them the game. Now, the lad who made the mistakes had a really good season. You know, he's played really, really well. Largely, you know, most of the season he's been one of Fulham's best defenders. Now, if you're going to look at individual mistakes, you can't, as a manager, you can't take ownership of individual mistakes.
Yeah.
That's down to players. All you can do is select them. But Jose's changed nearly all of his back four regularly and can't find a winning solution or stop the goals going in against his team.
I suppose then the question to the listeners this morning, and would love you to get involved on 0871 722 3344. You can text us as well at 81089 or tweet us at TalkSport. Who is at fault for something like what we saw in the game between Newcastle and Spurs? Is it the managers, which you are refuting in this situation?
In this particular, the two goals.
Or is it the players? Who would you be blaming right now if you're waking up Spurs fans for what you saw yesterday in that game at St James's Park? Do let us know.